A serial killer is terrorizing the normally sleepy streets of Salem.
This crude drawing of a bell has been left at the scene of several murders over the past few weeks.
Leading police to refer to the murderer as the Bell Killer.
We spoke with a public relations officer.
Authorities are asking anyone with any leads to contact the SPD's anonymous tip line.
The calling card the police have yet to attach any meaning or significance to has become synonymous with the hysteria surrounding his murder.
You're saying there are no leads?
No leads at all?
Grow up on the streets, you start thinking you're invincible. Nothing can touch you. You never really lose. Go to arrest some freak, find out you aren't as invincible as you thought.
What kind of name is Ronan?
That kid stole my wallet!
Time to make it official.
Ah, it hurts!
You steal my car, you pay the price. Ah!
You're under arrest for the assault and battery of Vincent Coulter.
Guilty on two counts of grand theft auto.
On the indictment of burglary.
Grand larceny. And assault with a deadly weapon.
Let me take it.
I can't have my sister marrying some bum, right?
They do.
Oh, yeah, I do. No. No, Julia. Stay with me, you hear me? Julia. No, stay with me! Stay with me! Your family wore felonies like badges of honor. Now you think this new badge covers all that up? You're a fucking criminal.
You need to slow down, man, right? This is crazy. I didn't know better. Say you actually want to die.
Turn around. You're under arrest.
Survive that. Stay where you are, dirtbag.
I'm coming back up.
You have the right to remain silent. Any cop you throw out of a window will hunt you down. Kick your ass. Damn it. The knob ain't even moving, it's stuck. Watch it, lady.
God.
No! I'm still alive. I can fix it. If I just get back in my body, then maybe I'll wake up. Yes.
Come on. Someone had to hear that glass shatter.
Ronan? I can't believe I found you.
Oh my God. Julia. I thought I'd never see you again.
You look good.
I look better. God, I've missed you.
I would give anything to be there with you. Be together again, but
what? No. Oh no, no, not again. Not you. If you're not here, where are you?
It's the other side of the bridge.
Bridge? What bridge?
Where you are is a prison. Or a bridge. It all depends on how you see it. Either way, where you are isn't safe. Do you hear me? We need to get you across the bridge. You need to move on.
Move on. Is that where you are?
Don't worry about me. Something about your life isn't finished yet. We don't have much time. Think. What about your life feels unresolved?
I don't know.
Figure that out. Now go.
No. Julia, you left me once and it destroyed me. Please, please don't leave me again.
We'll see each other again, love. Just save yourself.
No, Julia! Don't leave me, Julia! Damn it!
Hello? There's a man in the street outside the Regal Apartments bleeding. He's been shot. Send an ambulance.
He's not breathing.
My friend says he's not breathing.
I can't feel a pulse.
There's broken glass everywhere and a lot of blood.
Man. This is bad.
Yeah, I'll stay on the line until help arrives.
Hey, man. Can you hear me? Lady, please! Damn it.
Hey, you! Hey, can you hear me? Come back!
It's still warm.
Thank you.
Hey, why did you run?
It gets old, giving counsel to the new ones. Don't take it personal.
Running through walls, making things appear, you look like you've been here a while. You must know how this place works, then.
Works? This place isn't hard to understand. Figure out your gifts, and maybe you won't get trapped here.
What do you mean, gifts?
Your strengths in life are stronger in death. They become powers here. Some powers unique, some common. Possession, influencing people, manipulating the more fragile of ghostly objects to appear or disappear.
Strengths become abilities. Huh.
What do you want to know?
The door just hit me, but I'm passing through other stuff. What is it with this place? I thought I'd be able to walk through everything.
We can't enter the buildings the people of Salem have consecrated. Save through an opening. An open drawer, or a window. But once inside, walls and doors hold no power over us. You'll know the ghostly objects we can't pass through by their blue glow. It will all seem logical in due time.
Who are you? Looks like you've been here a while.
Me? I'm just someone like you. But hear me when I say this is no playground. You can rob yourself of your future, or others can do it for you.
I'm sorry, I don't understand what you're talking about. How could I rob my own future?
You're here to resolve something. You don't resolve it, you don't leave. Don't worry, that's pretty common.
Common? That's crazy. What do you mean others can steal my future?
Demons. They were once like us, but lost themselves. They can never move on now, and exist only to consume those lingering here. Those like us.
I getcha. I need to figure out who killed me and stop him. That's the way I can get out of here.
Well, best of luck to you.
Wait, there's more I need to know. Holy shit!
Be careful out there. You never know what's waiting around the corner.
Weird. Seeing your own body lying on the street. It's like looking in a mirror you don't want to see but can't turn away from. And that's when you realize you no longer know which one's real and which is the reflection.
Yeah, great idea, Baxter. Tamper with the evidence.
Backup? Who needs backup? You shouldn't have tried to be one of us. Man, you were one dumb son of a bitch. Sir?
Hey, Baxter, hey! Hey, just get back to taking them statements. Come on.
Yeah, I'm the stupid one.
But this is not your scene, Lieutenant. Just pay your respects and move on, please.
Yeah, maybe it's not my scene, but it is my case. Tomorrow it'll be my case, and the next day, until we catch him. You do well to remember that, Sergeant.
Look, I'm just following Captain's orders here. You know the procedure when a family member is... Yeah, well. Take all the time you need, LT.
I lost count of the times I wished you were dead. You do me a favor, Codman. Tell Julie I miss her.
She knows, Rex. She knows.
I need to find my killer's trail before it goes cold.
Get my eyes on Stuart's notepad. See what they've learned.
So did you see the man in the hood?
Yes. No, I saw him. He killed that man in the street.
I see. Look at all these people. He's got family.
It'd be nice to know what they're talking about. I gotta see if they found any leads that I don't already know about. The clues here have gotta tell me something.
Okay. Be patient with her. She's upset. She's not used to dealing with scenes like this.
Just stop talking.
And is that blood? I can't even imagine. What about his family? And I...
Hello?
Can't even believe that I'm dealing with this right now. This is just... It's...
saying he saw the bell killer enter a building. Ronan responds, disregards orders for backup. Next thing you know, the bell killer tried to see if he could make him sprout angel wings. And then bam, 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 bam.
Really,
seven to the chest.
You really,
point blank.
You really have no idea when to quit, do you, Baxter?
Ever take a look at those tattoos of his? All that gangland prison crap? He was more criminal than cop. Yeah, you live like a thief, you die like a thief.
He was still a badge, dickhead.
stay calm. People need the cops to be calm now. Jeez, Ronan. I can't even turn around to look. Just stay calm. People need the cops to be calm now. Jeez, Ronan. I can't even turn around to look.
Hard to believe that's a dead body right there. Glad I'm not a cop. Hard to believe that's a dead body right there.
Looks like the boys are doing everything we can do. This whole thing is just weird. All of us cops just getting nowhere.
I don't know what to do. I mean, why does this always happen to me? All I wanted was to go home and get a nice dinner and...
Hey, you okay?
I don't even know why am I even here thinking about this. I should just go home and get into bed under the covers and...
Okay. Be patient with her. She's upset. She's not used to dealing with scenes like this.
Right now. This is just... It's...
Just get her to calm down. Let her memory do its work.
How are we supposed to stay calm when they can't even protect their own? Why are cops so tight-lipped? Don't they know publicity will help them?
I could never do what she does. Amazing. It's like she hits a switch and she's on.
Probably all over the social media by now. The killer wouldn't come back to the scene, would he? This isn't possible. But there it is, right in front of me. Glad I wasn't here when it was happening.
tell people and it's like they think I'm in some movie. Can I take pictures with my phone? Is that legal? Of these little town beats. Can't wait till I get assigned to Boston.
Sure, there's more clues here.
What a night, huh, Robinson?
Yeah.
Crazy.
Doing here?
Asking for it. A witness called in saying he saw the Bell Killer enter a building. Ronan responds, disregards orders for backup. Next thing you know, the Bell Killer tried to see if he could make him sprout angel wings, and then bam, 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 bam.
Really,
7 to the chest,
you really
point blank.
You really have no idea when to quit, do you, Baxter?
Ever take a look at those tattoos of his? All that gangland prison crap? He was more criminal than cop. You live like a thief, you die like a thief.
He was still a badge, dickhead.
I saw it. That man in the hood. Outside. Looking up at the top apartment on the 4th floor, I think.
The killer came here for a reason. But what was it? There must have some clues. Except that's my way in, and it's closed. Fantastic. Here's my chance. I just need to follow Stuart into the building.
Hey, Sarge. 1019. Please return to the scene.
10-4.
Oh, it's just you. I knew I heard something.
Hey,
shit. You trying to give me another heart attack?
No, I just...
It was rhetorical, for God's sake. Come on, don't look so lost. Take a look around or something. You know, spy a little. It's not like anyone's gonna stop you.
I'm sure you saw the whole thing, and that makes you special. Always looking out the window, sticking your nose in everyone else's business.
I did see it, and I'm gonna have nightmares.
I think we've got enough nightmares to last us a while.
Don't talk about that. Don't ever talk about that.
I'm happy to stop talking. I'm trying to watch a show, you know.
Is Salem dealing with a serial killer? Details are still emerging, but for now.
You get a better view of the street on TV.
Staring out the window. What good's that gonna do?
Maybe if I stopped bringing him snacks, he might look around the room to see if I was still here. Look at that poor excuse for a man. Won't even get out of his chair. Likes that chair more than me.
Probably hear you talking through the ceiling.
I hope they do. Every time we visit Jennifer at this place, it's the same weird characters. That other lady on the second floor, she changes boyfriends like she changes sweaters. And my goodness, the racket.
I know that upsets you, dear.
And you know what else? Those guys on the third floor? You'd think they were trying to raise the dead. Speaking of dead, I'm pretty sure I heard shots outside. God, I wish she'd move out of this neighborhood. Are you listening to me? I need you to listen to me.
Yes.
My granddaughter needs a yard. Where does she play? The street? Can't wait for Jennifer to move out of this dump.
Hope he doesn't ask any questions. He'll know I've tuned him out. Gus needs some friends. Someone else who can listen to him yammer.
Thank you.
vodka chase in Salem, where Grizzly Murphy, normally sleepy but historical town, has run into quite a spree of violence. Only a few days ago, a young girl went missing, a string of mysterious murders and disappearances. Now, in a shocking turn, a police detective falls victim to what appears to be a brazen murder in public.
If I can just find it, then at least I'll know what happened. I've looked everywhere. Why did they do this to me? What if I never find it? If I only knew who it was, maybe I'd know where to look.
You look lost.
What's lost is my body. I know I got killed right here. And I know it sounds crazy, but I'd feel a lot better if I knew where my body was. Are you a detective or something? You might be my only hope.
Yeah, I'm a detective. Any idea who did it? That might lead us to your body.
I know they were old people, and I know they lived in this apartment building. Other than that, everything is hazy. But I was doing a lot of drugs at the time.
Sounds like you do need a detective. I'll see what I can find out from any older residents of the building.
Lately, only a few days ago, a young girl went missing on the heels of a string of mysterious murders and disappearances. Now, in a shocking turn, a police detective falls victim to what appears to be a crazy murder. In public, are these two connected?
You get a better view of the street on TV. That girl collapsed like paper when Grace hit her. I still can't believe she died. It happened so fast. I've never seen Grace so crazy before. It must have been the lack of sleep. Thank God it's all over. I can finally watch TV in peace.
Sleep through music blasting like that. I think she was on drugs. Walter was so tired, he could barely stay awake for the 5 miles it took to drive to Smithwick Quarry. I couldn't believe he was able to find a pair of lock cutters that late at night. At least the music has stopped. Now we can finally sleep.
Details are still emerging, but for now.
How the hell did it come back? Did I do that? Hey, come back!
Those notes aren't for you.
Great. Looks like some sort of code or something. All right, well, I made it up to the fourth floor before the police cart away the evidence.
Maybe she's getting too much sugar. I mean, that keeps kids awake, right? Just once, I'd like to have a nice phone conversation with an adult without interruption.
Monster like you end up in a kid's closet.
Her daddy pissed off the wrong people. I was the one sent to expedite things. It was simple. I grab the girl, make a few threats, collect the money, then let her go.
What went wrong?
Her daddy tried to be a hero and got in my way.
Looks like it worked.
It got him killed is what it did.
If you killed him, what happened to you?
The people I worked for weren't big on second chances, but it looks like I'll get one anyway. I just have to wait. Death comes for us all. Little girls are no exception. I've got nothing but time, my friend. I've got nothing but time, my friend.
Place your bets and hope your luck improves.
It ain't about luck, Everine.
You got that right, buddy. You might want to remember that when you're looking at your sorry track record.
Well, there's always some element of chance.
Maybe you'll teach us some tricks, eh?
Then I couldn't keep taking your lunch money, big guy. All right. Pull up your panties, gentlemen, and throw in some chips, Nate.
I want to let her win. But she's just gonna win anyway. I never know if she likes me or she's just being nice.
Or you're out.
Poor guys. I remember when I still thought poker was a game of chance. Good lord, these boys are easy pickings.
A few more good cards would help. Keep cool, big boy. Next hand, you take her down.
Cards are gonna biodegrade in your hand, mister.
Back off, will ya?
Thank you.
shocking turn, a police detective falls victim to what appears to be a brazen murder in public.
Looks like Grace couldn't take the girls partying anymore, so she killed her and roped her husband into helping dump the body at Smithwick Quarry. I should get back and let her know. Turns out, the reason you can't find your body is because it's not in the building. It's at Smithwick Quarry, about 5 miles out of town.
Oh. Well, why'd they do it?
Your parties were keeping them awake at night. They finally got too tired and snapped.
I thought they were just being unreasonable. I didn't know they would do this. Thanks for your help. You have no idea how big a relief it is just knowing.
No problem.
You know? I never really liked cops, and they were always giving me shit, telling me how I was messing up my life. We never saw eye to eye on things. But you really came through for me. Probably should have listened to what they were trying to tell me. Maybe then things wouldn't have ended up like this. Thanks again.
It's you. You're famous. Check out the TV.
I'm good. Thanks.
This is by far the worst birthday party ever.
We got brews. We got TV. What more do you want?
You know, I'd be fine just watching a video.
I mean, guess that's an idea. What, logistically speaking, how do we?
What's the use of a party if you have to plan it? That's like work. Why can't adventures happen without going outside?
shit. Why'd you do this to yourself, kid?
Voices. Those fucking voices. I was scared and alone. I just wanted them to stop.
Why didn't you turn to someone for help? A doctor or a friend or something?
No one listened. No one took me seriously. This was the only way to make them stop. There was just so much noise. But it's quiet now. Finally quiet.
I'm sorry, kid. It shouldn't have come to this.
Shh. You hear that? Silence.
Okay, folks, I need you to keep your distance from the scene here.
What happened up here?
I'm afraid that's still under investigation.
Guy got thrown out of a window. We're still looking at the details.
Thrown out of a window? By who?
Yeah, who did it?
Sorry, like I said, it's under investigation.
Is the building safe?
Yeah, is this building safe?
Perp didn't stick around, if that's what you mean.
No. They haven't caught the guy yet, but they're pretty sure he's not around now.
Officer Morgan.
Hey, they just want to know if some killer's lurking around, man. Just mellow out, okay?
Ma'am, the Salem Police Department will get to the bottom of this. Don't you worry.
If you don't have the suspect in custody, how do you know he's not still here?
Yeah, how do you know?
Actually, they're not sounding so sure now. Can I come stay at your place for a few days?
People, I understand your concern. I'd appreciate it if you just move along and let us do our work.
Why does everyone need the gory details? This isn't a party. This is a murder investigation.
Why doesn't this guy answer Jill? She's got good questions. God, why can't I think of anything original to ask? Why doesn't this guy answer Jill? She's got good questions.
I should make sure I stay with these people when I go. Don't want to be outside alone now. God, why don't they just tell us? What are they afraid of? That we'll be afraid of a killer? I'm afraid already.
Thank you.
seen that little girl that lives here? If she turns up, you come find me. Got it?
Gun. What was the killer doing here in the first place? What did I miss?
Man, we gotta find these tenants. If they're still alive.
I don't know how this will end. The killer is an enigma to the police and a lurking shadow in my own life. If only I can keep Joy from harm, I would do anything, even push her away, if it meant pushing her to safety.
I need to finish investigating before I go somewhere else. Turn around. You're under arrest. That's what I walked in on. Was he after the girl? Where'd she go?
should get this photo to Rex for that Amber Alert.
Have anywhere that I could stay just for a little bit?
Oh, of course, dear. The church is always here to help.
Out the window.
Gunned me down in the street, and you didn't even check for witnesses? Like you're untouchable. That girl is my only lead. I need to find her.
I still remember seeing the ad for the Regal Apartments in the paper. It's easy for people to look at it and see a dingy, run-down shithole. But me? I saw a place with history and character. I saw a place full of artistic inspiration. Before I knew it, I was the official tenant of Apartment 3A. Looking back on it, I wish I had never even unpacked. My new apartment turned out to have more character than I had anticipated. The carpets were occasionally soggy, the pipes were rusty, and I could hear the tenant below me banging against the walls and screaming at the top of his lungs. Sure, there were other problems with the place, but they just added to its charm. They were things I could live with. What I couldn't live with was showering in brown water, mysterious leaks molding the carpet, and obnoxious neighbors. I called the plumber, who arrived just as I was about to have a word with the people downstairs. When I showed him the wet spots on the carpet, he scratched his head and explained that nothing was leaking, and that the reason for the wet spots was most likely due to me spilling something and not realizing it. Did this guy take me for an idiot? I never spilled a thing. He apologized and said that without a leak, there's nothing he could do, so he moved on to the shower. Thankfully, the water had no trouble turning brown. He thought it could be an issue with a rusty boiler and went to check it out. I took the opportunity to address the tenants below. I knocked on the door, but no one answered. In fact, I couldn't hear anything at all. I tried the door, expecting it to be locked, but it just swung open. I was shocked to find it completely empty. That's when wet footprints began to appear on the floor. They were headed right for me. Just then, I could hear the plumber scream from the boiler room downstairs. By the time I ran down there, he was long gone, but he had discovered the source of the brown water. Packed into the old, rusty boiler was a bloated, decomposing corpse. The police are still investigating the homicide, and the landlord has promised to renovate the boiler room. However, despite his efforts, 3A is back on the market, and I doubt I'll ever feel clean again.
Best bet is to go out the window in that top floor apartment like the girl did. My best bet is to go out the window in that top floor apartment like the girl did.
I still hate heights.
Today, everything died for me.
wish ghosts were real and we could just talk to them. I'd accuse my boss of witchcraft in a heartbeat.
Right. I don't even know how I got here. I just want to go home.
Listen, I don't know if there's anything I can do, but it looks like you could use some help.
I don't know how I got here, or even where here is. I can't remember what happened to me. Why am I like this?
Sorry to tell you, kid. But if you're here, it means you're dead.
I knew it.
Look, I'm in a similar situation. Now, I used to be a detective. Let me take a look around and see if I can find anything that will help you make sense of all this.
I don't even know where you'd start.
Is there anything you remember? It doesn't matter how small. Sometimes the tiniest detail is all it takes.
I remember lots of people. And this rowboat. Everyone was scared. And I keep seeing the name Monahansett.
Well, that's a start. Let me see what I can do. This is her obituary. She died when her rowboat capsized and sank. Her body was never recovered. What was she doing on a rowboat? Looks like a memorial of some kind. I'll bet people left more than just this around here. Finding that stuff could help piece things together. Be deeply missed. You are a hero to us all. Huh. Hero to us all. Looks like more than one person owes her their lives. Victim. She was a hero. She saved a lot of people before her rowboat sank. She needs to know how much she meant to them.
Did you find anything?
That name you remember, the Mono Handset? Turns out it was a steamer ship that sank right outside of Salem Harbor. If it weren't for you, a lot of people would have died. You're a hero.
If I saved everyone, then how did I die?
No, you didn't save everyone, but you were trying to. Your rowboat capsized.
I can't swim, so I must have drowned.
I'm sorry.
No, don't be. Thanks to you, instead of fear and sadness, I feel pride. If it weren't for you, I would never have known. Thank you from the bottom of my heart.
I'm glad I could help.
running away. You need a sanctuary. A place where nothing bad can touch you. But you can never escape the questions. They follow you everywhere.
She's praying what I'm thinking.
Save us from the dark trials to come. Deliver us from the shadow.
If there's someone up there, please start protecting us.
Shadow of the evil one.
There's one promise I never regretted.
I'm sure it's just isolated victims he picks off.
At least I'm not alone.
Thank you.
Isn't there a clue about the church and the apartment?
Father, do you have anywhere that I could stay just for a little while?
Of course, dear. The church is always your deal. I think we have an old attic you can stay in, for as long as you like.
She's been staying in the attic? I better go check it out. Isn't there a clue about the church and the apartment?
Father, do you have anywhere that I could stay just for a little while?
Oh, of course, dear. The church is always your deal. I think we have an old attic you can stay in, for as long as you like.
She's praying what I'm thinking.
Save us from the dark trials to come.
Attic must be up there.
Brian is a lovely boy, but I worry about his family.
Well, his mother does seem to be a bit of a harpy, but Brian's worth it.
Yeah, I think so too, dear. It's just that Shelley didn't grow up around boisterous people, and I worry about the pressures of their relationship.
Oh, Sheila, they'll be fine. You know they'll have a long, happy life together.
Oh, I'm sure you're right. You've been her best friend since, what, fourth grade? I think in some ways you know her better than I do.
She's had a great role model for motherhood, I must say. When she has kids, they're just gonna blossom.
You're so sweet. I must admit I am looking forward to grandchildren. Has she said anything to you? I don't know, Angie. Brian is a lovely boy, but I...
not trying to be picky, but seriously, now do you call this a centerpiece?
I'm sorry, ma'am. The request form said it would be a Puritan-themed display. It wasn't a lot more specific.
Look at that. Just look at it. You call that Puritan?
This class.
Maintenance okay?
Oh, yes, sir. Just regular maintenance. These things are big enough for small animals to go hiking in. So we just have to make sure none of them...
High school sweethearts, you know. Everyone thinks they were, but they just seem like they've been in love forever. But they don't like that.
Shoo, cat, get out of here.
Thank you.
Angie. Brian is a lovely boy, but I worry about his family.
Well, his mother does.
There she is, finally.
Why do I always lose my keys when I need to leave?
How can I get through to her?
Possess me again. You have no right to dump your unfinished business
on
me.
Now, I'm tracking down my killer, okay? Someone who was seconds away from attacking you about an hour ago, and if...
Wait a minute. You can see me? And hear me? Holy shit. You're a medium. Well, ain't I the luckiest guy in the world. I just found the perfect little helper.
What is it with you guys and my family? Helping the cops do their job is not some privilege. It's a trap. I'm not your informant, your partner, or your friend. I don't owe you. If anything, you owe me. Dick.
Yeah, I get it. You're tough, okay? But you're not tougher than him. You saw what he can do. He's coming after you, or someone close to you.
Whoever he wants dead is lucky to still be alive. Now, I know what I'm doing, and you can help me stop him. All you have to do is answer some questions.
Look, I'm sorry. What happened to you is horrible, and you saved my life, so what do you want? I'm telling you, I'm out of here soon.
I was murdered tracking that son of a bitch to your place. So why would he be looking for you?
That freak was probably looking for my mom. Not me. I'm a nobody. Invisible. My mom and I tried very hard to keep it that way. Not everybody wants to be noticed, you know.
Looking for your mom. What does that mean?
She's like me. But she found a way to make a respectable living off of what we can do. Living that probably turned her into a target. Thought you were gonna ask me something.
So where's your mom, kid?
Probably dead. She would never just leave me without saying a word, never. I don't know where she is. I know the Bell Killer had something to do with her disappearance. Him showing up tonight just proves it.
If he killed her, why would he come back to her place?
I don't know.
Look, assuming the worst never helped no one. Why don't you live there?
Because of people like you, always asking for help. Trying to connect one last time with your loved ones or resolve some crazy problem. I love my mom, but I can't live in one place for too long, or people like you will find me too easily.
I wasn't home much either growing up. I know that's rough. All right. What were you doing at your apartment?
I live there, Sherlock. Well, I used to, whatever. My mother has been missing for a few days. I don't see her that often, but she never just disappears. Not like this.
Have you ever seen my killer before tonight? Do you have any idea who he is?
You cops are so hard up on clues that you're actually asking people if they know who the killer is? Now I get why you need so much help.
I'm not asking people. I'm asking the witness whose life I just saved. Respectable living?
Yeah. Hey, you might know her. She was working the Bell Killer case with the cops as a contract psychic, a profiler.
Sorry, kid. She didn't ring any bells.
I found this in the apartment tonight. Mentioned something about some Bell Killer book, and it's in her handwriting.
Bell Killer book? If she was a profiler, it's probably the book she kept all her case notes in. That would be at the station.
Really?
You're not safe alone. You need someone watching over you. Us cops find missing people. I found you, and I can help you find your mom. Your problem is now my problem, too.
No way. Don't get me wrong. You saved my life, and... Okay, I can't pay that back, but... Your problems are your problems, and mine are mine. There they are. Good luck. You're gonna need it. Have a nice afterlife.
Whoa, wait a minute. Don't go yet. Just stop for a second, will you? We're on the same side. If your mother's involved, we need to work together.
Work together? What are you gonna do? You're dead. I'll handle it. Just leave me alone!
I bet she knows more. I can't let her get away. There's gotta be another way down.
Come back!
Leaving so soon, dear?
Yeah, sorry. I'll be back. Don't wait up, Father.
Be careful out there, my child.
She calms down. I'll go ask her why she needs to stay here.
Damn it. Now what? Jesus. So, where'd she go, huh?
Station and don't look back.
Yeah. She's headed to the police station to steal some book. She'll blend in well there. Did you know her mother worked for the police? Fine. Don't tell me. Puss.
Station.
I see exactly what I mean. Why is that so hard to understand? If she doesn't want to be in a relationship, she should be direct about it. More of those historical plaques. Said nobody ever.
Not going that way.
And Lord, they're dead. It's all my fault. We were just having fun. It was an accident. I didn't mean to hurt anyone. I can't even remember doing it.
Hey. Calm down for a second and talk to me. What's your name?
Brad.
Good. Now, tell me what happened.
I don't know. We were out in the town blowing off some steam. One drink turned into three, and three turned into... who knows how many. The details are hazy. I must have been driving Rick and Laura home when... Oh, God. I killed them. I'll never forgive myself for doing this.
You don't know if you did. You said it yourself. The details are hazy. Now I can take a look around here and see if anything jumps out at me.
God, what have I done?
This must be Brad's car. It's not looking good. Much, but it's something. Gas station's not far from here. I should check it out.
Is this what you wanted? You said I was the one. More like one of many. I don't even know what he sees in her. Look at him. What a pig. He doesn't even feel guilty about what he did. Just look at him staring at her.
Rough breakup?
He betrayed me. He said he'd love me forever, but he's marrying someone else. Did he cheat on me with her? I always thought there was someone else. Was it her?
Does it matter? It looks like he's moved on. Maybe you should too.
I can't. Not until I know the truth. Please, I must know. For better or worse.
All right. I'll look into it.
I still don't know what she got herself. Everything seemed great. Guess that's why I'm so nervous with Susanna. The thing is, if she hadn't jumped off that cliff, I never would have found my real soulmate. Man, it's so messed up.
Looks like he met this girl after his ex died.
Thank you.
always been so hesitant. I wouldn't blame him, but it sucks that she's the reason I even approached him. He looked so hurt and broken, like he needed someone to talk to. I didn't expect to fall in love with him. Weird how things work out.
She was just trying to be a friend. She never anticipated this. Misunderstanding. I'm not sure how she'll take it, but I guess I'll find out.
The good news is he wasn't cheating on you. The bad news is your suicide brought them together.
So he really loved me?
Looks like it.
I've made a big mistake.
He still thinks about you. Maybe you can take comfort in knowing that you'll never be forgotten.
I suppose. I just wish I had trusted him more. Maybe it could have been us getting engaged. What's done is done, I guess. Anyways, thanks for everything.
not going that way.
Cab. What? Oh. Gas station. Yeah. The SOC. Okay. Great.
You're such a lightweight.
strange coming back here now, like this. A place I used as a crutch to get through the tough times when I found myself suddenly alone again. Funny how history repeats itself.
Not tonight. Tonight was the first time he used a gun. This guy relies on close proximity. So remember, if you approach him, it gives him power.
But, sir, if we can't approach him, how do we arrest him?
Remember your training. He's a wanted cop killer now. You can shoot him on sight.
Bell Killer War Room.
No, sir. I'd be very interested to know that myself.
Wish I could say that's the weirdest thing I saw tonight.
Yes, Captain? No, I'm sorry, what? We should try what?
Killer's flesh and blood like all of us.
No. No suspects at this point, sir.
This boils down to sloppy leadership, Lieutenant. Whoever made the call for Ronan to go in alone, it's on you. We lose one of our own tonight, and you have no suspects and no leads?
Look, Captain, he wore gloves and apparently didn't touch anything in the apartment other than the knob on the front door. He didn't leave prints, fibers, or anything else traceable. And if you think I don't want this guy to pay more than you, you are sadly mistaken.
Watch your tone, Rex. Everyone knows he was your brother-in-law, so you don't need to remind us. But you lose your cool again, and more of your own will join Ronan. You understand me? You find this guy, or a clue that leads to his doorstep. Now! That's an order.
Yeah, understood.
Gotta have faith in the department. Gotta do our work. Cops, gotta stick together.
When was the last time a badge from here died on duty?
Never. Ronan's the first. Wonder if that girl knows something. We couldn't drag him away from this case now. There are reasons for going by the book.
What were you in for?
It's too complicated to get into. Let's just say that I wasn't about to let some judge decide how to spend the rest of my life. That's my choice, so I made it. Either way, no, it doesn't matter now, does it?
If it didn't, you wouldn't still be here. Maybe I can help?
Nah, I appreciate it, but you know, it looks like you got your own shit to deal with. I'll figure it out on my own. Always have. Thanks, though. Do what you gotta do. I'll be fine.
Gotta get out of here. There's a ghost right over there in that cell. Don't you have some other place you can keep me?
Shut up. If only I could tell my younger self what I would become.
Another one! Tell me you can't see this guy. He's right there.
Someone get this guy to the looking bin already.
Can they really not see this? The ghost is right there.
Wrong cell. Yours should have padded walls. If I ask what happened?
What does it look like? I died.
Yeah, I can see that. I meant, how did you die? Autopsies aren't this thorough when the cause of death is cut and dry.
I don't know. A bunch of pills. Some were sleeping pills. It was supposed to be peaceful. I didn't know that you wake up. What am I supposed to do now?
I wish I knew, kid. I'll let you know if I figure it out myself.
This is all a bad dream. It has to be. This is all a bad dream. It has to be.
Isn't a spiderweb tattoo usually a symbol for time spent in prison? Why would this tattoo have two spiders in the web? He got his own tattoo wrong.
It's just a tattoo. That's all I know. Little respect would be nice.
Are those prison bars?
We don't pay you to analyze tattoos.
Yes, sir. Wow. His entire arm looks like a confession of a lot of stuff.
We respect the deceased in here, son. Don't forget that.
But tattoos might tell us something.
sickness she carried in her brain? You made it tolerable. Well, I guess you must be together now.
Hasn't screwed up yet, but he will.
Find that info about the missing tenant.
I think I've learned all I can here. I better go find that witness.
Baxter, you still relying on that wizard lady?
You know I ain't into all that spiritual crap. But she's onto something. Results are results. You find a more reliable source, you let me know.
I can still remember my first day on the force. Salem PD was in this tiny building on the edge of town. It was old, crowded, and completely insufficient to handle the day-to-day operations. Protecting Salem was getting harder and harder. Finally, the city decided to convert the old armory into our new headquarters. And when we finally moved in, I couldn't believe how big and modern the place was. Not bad for one of the first buildings in Salem. Plus, it just felt right. It used to be the city's first line of defense in a wild frontier, and now it had resumed its post once again, only this time in a modern world. The first week was a little chaotic as we settled in. One officer reported that someone had removed his gun from his locker. It took him 20 minutes to track it down, and when he did, he found it leaning against the wall in one of the unoccupied offices. Also, the late-night station operator reported a strange phone malfunction. Occasionally, when someone would call in to report a shooting, the recording would just stop. The call would cut out, and the voice of the panicked caller would just loop over and over again until the phone was unplugged. Soon it was pretty clear that these strange occurrences weren't just honest mistakes or faulty phone lines. One evening, the medical examiner came running down the hall in tears. She noticed that her scalpels and other tools had gone missing. She went to get more from the cabinet, but stopped cold at what she saw in the reflection. A ghostly silhouette of a Civil War soldier was standing over one of the corpses. She spun around, he was gone. She barely noticed how cold the room had gotten before running off. Of course, the guys didn't believe her. Hell, I didn't either. Till I saw it with my own eyes. I was working late and got up to get more coffee. As I rounded the corner, I saw it in the reflection of the trophy case. It was staring right at me. He lifted an old, ghostly rifle and pulled the trigger. The trophy case fractured into a spider web of cracked glass, and I took off running. The captain didn't believe me and docked my next paycheck to replace the glass. I didn't care if people thought I was crazy. I know what I saw. People sometimes ask me if anyone else has seen it since, or if the specter still roams the halls. I always tell them the same thing. I wouldn't know. I transferred to Boston.
I can't tell you anything, son. I'm not in homicide.
I've only been in the department for 6 months. I just... Do cops get killed? A lot?
No, I wouldn't say it happens. I've been on the force nearly 20 years. And I'm still alive.
Shakes you up when it does happen. Anymore, because it doesn't happen often.
Not that we want it to happen more often.
Get out here on Sunday, of course.
Robinson's got the girl in the room right now.
Think she knows anything?
I will find out. Robinson seems like a gentleman, but he's got his methods of persuasion.
Yeah, he's a smooth one. I want to meet him. I don't know how she could be related to this.
Label your stolen keys. Each one of these keys is a felony. Each one. You get that, right? No? All right, it's your funeral. Sit tight, relax. You're gonna be here for a while.
Fuck!
All right, look. Look. I might be able to help you. Is your mom's book from the Bell Killer case here?
Yes, and it would probably help me find my mom, but as I told you before, you're dead. How can you possibly help me?
Hey, I know this place better than you. Now, who did your mom work with here? Who?
I don't know. She just called him Bastard.
Baxter. All right. His office was on the second floor. You stick with me, I'll get you there. Let's go.
Go where? They're watching.
Not for long. Follow my lead. I'll get you past these cops and to the door on the other side.
Piece of cake.
Yeah. Last time you got caught, Magellan. Stay low or they'll see you.
Easy, but stay low. Keep going.
That's not supposed to happen.
Go for it.
Nice job, kid. We're almost there.
I don't need a cheerleader.
Hey, I got us this far, didn't I?
Got yourself killed, Mr. Bullet Holes.
Hey, kid.
I hate these things.
I can't get across there. You're gonna have to help me.
Well, can't you just fly over it?
Fly? I'm a ghost, not a plane, all right? And look, you need me to tell you which office is his.
Duh. Don't read any of my thoughts, or think anything creepy. Oh, if this doesn't make us even... Okay, man, get out.
I got this.
Freaky.
Stay low, but go faster than that. Detectives usually work the day shift.
Okay, but which office is Baxter's?
It's in the back hallway to the right.
Okay.
Are you trying to get caught? You're about as stealthy as a tornado.
Ugh, the desk was like that when we got here.
Yeah, I know.
How many places can you hide a book in one tiny little room?
Who knows?
Was hiding your real rap sheet. Now I have proof.
He never used that blackmail file against me.
Sure, take your time. No rush, I'm sure the book will bind itself.
All right, just calm down a second here. Cops don't hide things in plain sight. I just need to figure this out. Can you check that voicemail message?
Okay.
Baxter, I told you, you're off the case. Now we need all the files and that psychic's book in my office, now.
Rex was still asking for the book, so it is probably still in here somewhere. Good.
Murder changes, the inner zeal is the same. This is why the killings seem random, unrelated. But the police can't see these connections. Except Officer Baxter. I can't say I trust him, but he's my only chance.
Come on, we have to find that journal.
Thank you. I better tell the girl. I think I found it.
Show me.
There's a button on the side of the gun rack.
Yes, this is it.
Oh, please tell me you understand what all these symbols are.
Yes, some of them. That's weird. The last thing she wrote is he knows about me. Oh, God. That means he was after her.
You don't know that. Come on, we should move.
Oh, crap.
Wait, what is that? The museum. That's strange.
Why would this be in her book?
I don't know. Just take it and figure it out later.
She's here somewhere. I'll check here. Head toward the back office.
We gotta go. Stay out of sight.
Go, go!